Be doing a review on LightSigUSA.com's new VX2. It's an electronic cigarette. Comes packaged in a very nice box. I've never seen a mini package like this. It's the only mini besides the Smoke Everywhere that I've ever bought that comes with the box with a little magnetic flap on it. That's usually only pen styles and the likes of those that have that. Comes very nicely packed. Comes with a little card that shows when it was inspected and the instruction booklet. We'll get to that in just a second. The VX2 is a model J118, and a lot of people are comparing it to 901s. As a matter of fact, a lot of people are saying that they're the new 901. First, let me show you the differences real quick. Get one out of here. This is the VX2 battery. It is actually a female end, and this is the VX2 atomizer right here. It's a male end, so it's different from a 901 right off the bat. Okay, it's the VX2 atomizer and the VX2 battery. Just to show you the difference, we've got a 901 atomizer and a 901 battery. On the 901, the battery is a male end. On the VX2, it's a female end, and vice versa with the atomizers. Like I said, a lot of people are comparing the VX2s to 901s, and other than size, which I'm going to show you here, put the cap on for the VX2. The size with the 901 and the VX2, they are absolutely the same dimension. It looks like the diameter on the VX2, which is on this side, is just a tiny bit bigger than a 901. Also, where they connect, the band for the 901 in the battery is about a quarter of an inch lower than the VX2. We'll compare the two vapor production in just a second. The VX2, which I said is a J118, comes with 5 cartridges, and they have a little piece of foil that covers the end. I was confused on this, so I actually called Sean at LightSig USA and found out you just push the cartridge right onto the atomizer. You can barely see it in there, but the atomizer on the VX2 is shaped more like this than a regular atomizer being shaped like this. That form right there, the crown that it comes to, actually punctures your cartridge. So we're going to stick a cartridge on there. You know, listen to it snap on there. Go. Little tight fit. Another thing with the VX2 is there are no atomizer holes around the atomizer. There's a little trick to that. The holes for the atomizer are actually on the threads right around there. When you put the atomizer on the VX2 battery, it screws together really nice and fits just like that. Well, what you cannot see unless you hold it up to a light is there is a little gap between the atomizer and the battery, thinner than a sheet of paper. You can't even see it looking at it with your naked eye, but if you hold it up, you can see the light pass through the little spot. Really nice design. I like how that happened, or how that fits together, and there's no holes to worry about covering up and burning out your atomizer. Let's give it a little try here. as you can see, brand new cartridge, just put on. Really nice. Also, with the VX2, I don't know if any of you caught that, there is no primer puff needed. Okay, don't need to do the regular 901 little puff to get it going and then a nice drag. With the VX2, it has got the easiest pull of any e-cig I've had. Okay, it just pulls really easy, really clean. We're gonna rate it real quick. A lot of vapor. Okay, I'm gonna give it, on a scale of 1 to 10, I'm gonna give it an 8.5 on vapor. It's not quite as good as my e-cigars, but it's a lot smaller than an e-cigar. This is a cigar compared to the VX2. Give it an 8.5 on vapor. Definitely got the throat hit. For a mini, I'm going to rate it pretty high on a throat hit. It's given me about a 7 on throat hit. So vapor production, 8, 8.5. Throat hit, about a 7. Design is great. First battery I had on this, I got 11 hours out of. Now that's just how I personally vape. I'm what I call a puff-puff pocket vapor. I take, when I need my little fix, I take it out and I take 2 or 3 drags, stick in my pocket, and I'm good for half hour, 45 minutes, maybe an hour sometimes. My battery lasted me 11 hours on its first initial 12-hour charge. A lot of vapor, great taste. I'm just using the regular carts that came with it. They're a high. The design, I know why people want to compare it to the 901, but I would say it's a far, far, far superior design. In terms of how long the battery lasts, the atomizer is not even warm, okay? Just a nice little pull on it. Atomizer is not even warm. This is 901. I'm going to try it again. Didn't get any vapor out of the 901 that time. Okay, that's a regular 901, fully charged battery. This is the VX2, fully charged battery. Yeah, it wasn't a very good hit there. I've not had a dead draw from it, but I've had to kind of figure out the length of my inhales on this, because sometimes you don't get quite what you would with an analog. And everybody knows that's just experimentation, but let's try it again. Good one. Okay. It's superior to a 901 in vapor production, battery length, how long the battery lasts, design is better. I give it a 9 out of 10 all the way around. It's a great, great device. It is now my second. I use my cigars primarily and my pens secondary, but I feel it's actually better than a pen. So I would suggest getting one. I give it 9 to 9.5 straight across the board. Now for the negatives. There is only one real negative that I have, and that is